Late in 2014, mining giant Rio Tinto announced it would wind down its operations at its alumina refinery in the Northern Territory town of Nhulunbuy. It was a massive economic blow which left many fearing for the future. But 18 months on, things are starting to turn around in the top-end town. Rio is ramping up its operation at its bauxite mine, and the local Gumatj people are stepping up to fill the void left by the loss of some of the town's businesses. Natalie Ahmat spoke to some of the local mob to find out how they're doing.
I'm here at the Roy Marika Lookout, which overlooks the town of Nhulunbuy. Now, about 18 months ago, this tiny town and many of the Yolngu communities not far from here were devastated when Rio Tinto announced plans to wind back operations at its alumina refinery. More than 1,000 people lost their jobs and many of them left town. That had a flow-on effect for many of the services and businesses who were also forced to shut their doors. But a year and a half on, things are starting to look up.
You know, from where we started 10 years ago, we've come a long way. We've got my father's vision and the board of directors was to get people into jobs and employment. We're doing it. So it's looking up for us.
And while Rio Tinto may have curtailed its operations at its refinery, mining remains a big part of this town. They still mine for bauxite here, and the Gumatj are even getting in on the act themselves, at the weekend announcing they're opening their own mine and training centre.
This came out as an idea from actually the Gumatj from Gularoy, to his vision to have a training centre to get young kids to come through, be trained up, and start small-scale mining and then become a mid-sized mining company. So I congratulate the Gumatj with a vision, and Rio Tinto has come in behind that with financial support of $2.4 million. And this is the start of the construction of the men's accommodation area.
We, the landowners, would always say, you know, if we had the right moment or what we got, like the mining agreement and what came out of there, we'd always be, you know, looking forward to mining our own land. What belongs to us should be mined by us, yes.
But the Gumatj are being careful not to put all their eggs in the mining basket. They're investing monies made through mining royalties into other businesses and training opportunities in the town.
To be honest with you, we're so diverse, and we are diverse for a reason, that we can offer jobs right across the board. We've got fishing, we've got abattoirs, we just bought a butcher shop in town.
I'm here inside the local butcher shop in Endeavour Square, which is right in the centre of Nhulunbuy. And this business was opened about 3 weeks ago by the Gumatj Corporation as a way of diversifying their interests outside of mining. And who should I run into but a man that might be familiar to many of our NITV viewers from Move It Mob Style.
There you go.
Brother, what are you doing here?
Me and my brother, we're here. We started our apprenticeships through our Gumatj meets about... Well, I started mine about 3 weeks ago, and I'm actually under my little brother Murphy, and it's something different when I'm not busting a move, moving a mob style. I'm here chopping a chop, getting it meat style.
So Murphy, you're the boss of the two of you. Anyway, tell us, how did you come to be working here at the butchers?
First of all, I started off working at, we had a whole crew of indigenous young boys, so we were doing grounds maintenance, so we would go around all the houses that LJ Hooker owned, and we would just mow the lawns and that, and clean it up, make it look nice and neat, ready for them to move in. And then I was working for the grounds maintenance for about, I'll say a year, and then just recently I got a job offer, or not a job, an offer, an apprenticeship in butchers, and I was like, why not?
Which we enjoy hunting, it's just a natural thing for us to cut up meat, and so now we're getting qualified at tickets doing it, so it's pretty good.
What I want to do is, when I finish my apprentice, I would like to run this shop and have other indigenous young fellas, you know, I want to pass it on, you know, so when I'm gone, there'll be local boys running this shop, you know, and it'll be so deadly.
We're the first ones to get our foot in the door and get an apprentice up and running and training. So we're pretty stoked, and that's something that we can use and give back to the community over time.
So, moving up, mixed style.
So while things are improving here in Nhulunbuy, there is still a way to go. The town still faces many challenges, particularly around the high unemployment rate, and housing and health remain ongoing concerns. But talking to a lot of the residents here, there really is a feeling that things are on the up. And the good news is that traditional owners are right at the centre of trying to find some of the solutions. In Nhulunbuy, I'm Natalie Ahmat for NITV News.